First of all, thanks for clicking and I'm sure you're having a fantastic day. In this video, I will show you how to make this video game interface design and very fancy game-like button design. And the background of this design is also made in Figma. And I'll go through this step by step, so I hope you'll watch the full video. Hi, this is ababir. Welcome to my channel Design Thinking. Let's get into it. These are the assets that I'm gonna work with to build this design. A long image to make the background, few demo logos and icons, a texture, and another image for another background. So let's start making this background first. Let's pick a frame and rename it. Now let me just drag this image into the frame. Make a duplicate of this frame. Just move the image to the right and inside the frame. Let's place a solid rectangle. Make it black with a slight opacity in it. Then I'll apply the background blur. Copy and paste it into the second frame. I'll convert this into components and combine this as variant. Let's prototype this. For auto animation, I'll set this to after delay. Maybe with a 50 millisecond delay. And set this to smart animate. And vice versa. Now let's place this to the main screen. Drag it from the asset tab. Okay, now I'll draw another frame for the card. Let's place this background image inside this frame. As you saw, I pulled the image inside the frame from the layer tab. Let's draw another black rectangle with slight opacity and background block. I'll draw another rectangle in it and put this out of this particular frame, not the main frame, but the curved frame. Remove the fill and give it a thick orange border. Look fancy. Now, a simple trick that I do to make an even gap in the border. Let's draw a small rectangle and center this. Double click on the border and add two more edit points on either side of the rectangle. Remove the middle one. Bring both points to the edge of the rectangle. Now just remove the rectangle. If there is any easier way, just do that. Let me know in the comment section too, so that I can learn that too. Now let's populate this with some elements. A logo, a demo text, a fake one. This is an element to place the button in it. A very simple construction with four orange corner and inner border and a dark solid layer and a bit of a light solid layer. Now let's start making the first button. It's a 90 by 90 pixel square. Give it a dark color and a bit light border. Give it a smaller inner border. Also, I'm gonna give it four orange corner with the thick border in it. Now group it. And make it a frame. Rename this. Okay, this is our hover state. Let's make the normal neutral state, the initial state. Select four corner from the layer tab and make the opacity to 0. Make another copy and make the corner white. Now select both of this and make another copy. And press Ctrl D two more times to make four more duplicates. Sorry. Finally, let's make a copy of this one. And give it a bit darker color. Make this component to make a component variant. By the way, I'm using lots of keyboard shortcuts here. If you want to see a video on it, just let me know in the comment section. Now, prototype this. Set the first one to while hovering. And I do not want anything to animate here. Set this to after delay with a 20 millisecond duration. Apply the same for the rest of the button frame too. Finally, the last one with the same setup. Okay, my button is ready. Now let's place this on the main screen. Drag this from the asset tab. I want three of these. Populate with a few more elements. And place this icon too.
Well, this is done.
Okay, now let's move on to the final button. Give it a color. This button will be a corner cut design. Place the corner and subtract, then flatten. Now let's mask the texture to give the button corner cut shape and place it on the top. Place the text. And now I'll draw a white straight line. Okay, now group it, make it a frame. From here, I will go back to the main initial step. As I want this line to grow while I click on it, I will just reverse this. Set this to 1. Make another copy. And make the opacity to 0. Now set this one width to 1. Next frame, make this one also 1. And the opacity of the previous one to 0. Same for the next one. But as you can see, instead of right, it shrinks to the left. In this case, I'll just flip it. Then make the width 1. Make the opacity to 0. Finally, the final state. But I'm not done yet. I also want the blinking effect here too, so make it white. And make some copies of this too. Now convert to components very quickly. Then I'll convert it to component variant. Rename this. Now prototype this. This one will be on click, and I'm gonna use the smart animate here. Set this to 100 milliseconds. From the next one, it will be after delay, but with the same smart animate. I'll just apply the same till the last one. With that, the second button is done too. Let's place this one on the main screen. drag and drop. Perfect. Everything seems all right. Let's see the output. Okay, the background is moving too fast. Let's fix that. Let's go to the background frame and click on the prototype connector. I'll make this to 10 seconds instead of 1. Now it looks much better. Okay, the issue number 2 is this button is getting clicked while hovering. So let's fix this too. This one is set to while hovering, which is fine, but the second one should be on click. And the issue is fixed. The final design is looking great, isn't it? In my future video, I'll show you how to make an animated drop-down menu and hamburger menu. So I hope you'll stick around for that. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want more videos like this, please subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.